సమావేశాలు ముగిసే అవకాశం కనిపిస్తుంది. సభ ముందుకు వచ్చిన 5 బిల్లులపై సభ్యులు తమ అభిప్రాయాలు వ్యక్తం చేశారు. రాజ్యసభ సమావేశాలు కొనసాగుతున్నాయి. లైవ్ లో చూద్దాం.
The provisions of the bills grossly diluting the and tampering all the provisions pertaining to rights and protections of the workers in general. So even on the health of the safe related matters, the code has no the code has so
honorable member, could you put on the mask please?
It's very voice is not clear, that's why I was articulated the provisions as the workers and the unions cannot assert their opinions and rights. Proper enforcement to establish the accountability of the employers for violation of even basic health and safety provisions. The code has not dealt with adequately and even imaginatively with the issues concerning occupational safety and health. The further Factories Act stipulates the compulsory constitution of biopatriot safety committee in every factory in which hazardous process or substance are used, but code leaves the constitution of the safety committee in the notification process for appropriate government. The code requires the employers to seek prior consent from the workers to perform overtime. It's a good move. For the first time legislative history, this code requires every employer to issue appointment letter, but it does not stipulate a remedy in case of non-compliance of it. Codification is necessary to rationalize proximate labor laws, but this should not lead to building together diverse and unique laws concerning disparately positioning categories work of workers which are yet to mature in the meaningful piece of legislation in their own right are historical and hence need respective suitable amendments. Next, with regard to the trade, central trade unions, the industrial trade relations code, the legislation subsumes with the three central labor laws and provides a comprehensive code. I am concerned with only an adjudicating body at appeal level. How it will be effective resolving labor disputes when prolonged disputes resolution will not defeat the very purpose of rendering justice and welfare to the laborers across the country. As far as the definitions are concerned, its wages is narrow than under the Industrial Dispute Act. The changed definition would have an impact on the quantum of compensation payable to a worker in the event of retrenchment and closure. With regard to the recognition of trade unions, the code provides for recognition of trade unions as bargaining agent. The requirement is of the support of 75% of the workers for recognition as a sole negotiating agent is too high and not in conformity with the principles relating to collective bargaining laid down by the ILO supervisory bodies. Restrictions on strikes. Under the Industrial Relations Code, workers in all industrial establishments are required to give notice of minimum 14 days and maximum 60 days before going on strike. Under Section 63, Clause 63, upon giving such a notice, conciliation proceedings are deemed to have commenced and the strike cannot continue during the pendency of the conciliation proceedings and the adjudication proceedings. This would make it difficult for workers in any industrial establishment to go on a legal strike. No reference with regard to the requirement under Section 10 of the Industrial Dispute Act. There is no provision requiring reference of industrial dispute for adjudication. However, in case of disputes of national importance, the central government needs to refer the dispute for adjudication by national industrial tribunal. Coming to the Code of Social Security Bill, the code it is a short span time the bill has been brought for discussion, though it has been reported department related standing committee laborer that there are a lot to be done. Many members have given a dissent on this report also. Sir, this bill subsumes 9 central labor acts with it. It includes